Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. I hope everybody's doing well. So for today's video I'm gonna show you guys how to do root pass on a horizontal weld, horizontal joint. I'm gonna show you a technique and we're gonna talk a little bit about the prep. As you know, usually the pipe comes with a land or any manufacturer end. I already got land. In this case it's almost 1/8. As you can see, I'm using 1/8 TIG rod for this root, so definitely we have to remove that land, and we're gonna do, that's what I always do, it's a feather edge. So the bevel is 30, it always ranges from 30 to 45 degrees bevel angle. This one is 37.5, that's pretty much regular in pipe fitting for prepping the pipe. That's what it usually is, 37.5. So for the gap rod, it's 532. This is what I'm aiming for, the gap. I like to have 532 gap pretty much on my welds. Sometimes I even go even 316 for horizontal, but no need in this case. This is only demo, just to show you a technique how to do a horizontal root pass. As you can see, as long as I can wiggle that 1/8 rod, that's a good gap for me. Now I'm going to do three root tacks. This is going to be the first one. As you can see here, I'm using cup size 8. And I'm going to show you an example how to do a root tack. Okay, for the root tack, 115 amps. Usually I don't go that low with the amps. I'm always around 130, 140 range, especially on a horizontal weld. But this is only for educational purposes, so 150, I'm gonna go a little bit slow, low and slow, just to show you guys how to do it. As you can see, the connection I did, top, bottom, connect, and try to keep it connected, that rod in the middle. The tanks is gonna push, the amps is gonna push that puddle inside, so you're gonna have, I'm aiming for the good, nice, solid root. Is they gonna be the part of the root later. Okay, this is the root from outside and this is for the inside. Looks good. That's exactly what I'm aiming for. Thickness is nice. And now I'm gonna do the other one. It's gonna be on a 6 o'clock side. So as you can see here, it's 4, 4.5, almost 5 mil gap. And I'm trying to do 1 inch in length. As long as they're 1 inch in length, I'm hoping the gap I'm making is gonna stay the same. As you know, the shrinks a lot, pulls a lot. That's why I'm hoping it's gonna stay the same. That's why I go with a 1 inch root tacks. And it's easier, you know, if you got longer tacks, when you do root, it's gonna be easier to, you know, to be the part of the root to be integrated, and it's gonna be less visible. That's what I'm aiming for. As you can see here, the rod I'm keeping, it's pretty much 50-50 on the edge, in and out, and pushing that rod in, stretching that puddle up and down. Okay, this is the second one. Now we're gonna see which side is the wider on 3 and 9 o'clock. Okay, so here on the 9 o'clock, I got a little bit less than 4 mil. And let's check here on the 3 o'clock. Yeah, it's almost 5 mil. So on the wider side, this is where I'm gonna put tack. So this is the third one. Nothing fancy, you know, there's a couple different tacks you can put. You can put a bridge tack, you know, standard tack, or using a bridge rod. But for this, I'm gonna go with the root tacks on horizontal. I think it's very, it's way better to have a root, unless you do stainless, of course, then you want to do a bridge tax. But for carbon pipe, definitely you can go with the root tax. Okay, so I got all three in. So we got 12, 3 and 9 o'clock. Okay, now I'm gonna grind both sides of each tack. So we're gonna have entry and exit point. This is gonna be start point as well. On the one side, there's I'm gonna start from the tack, like from the half of that tack. I'm gonna start, and I'm gonna start doing root on this side. As you can see, the rod's gonna be inside. And then we're just gonna keep that rod inside and stretch that puddle. So I'm gonna switch to cup size 6. Cup size 6 fits perfect in that bevel, so I can just slide, you just wiggle that cup inside, and it's gonna be easier to have a control with that over that puddle. If you go with the cup size 8, it's not fit perfectly inside that bevel, so any obstacles outside on the surface, you might, you know, interrupt you or slow you down or whatever, you know, you can have missteps or something. So the stick out, as I said, 1/8 2% toriated tungsten. For the stick out, usually the reference is on the inside that edge, or usually it's up to 9 to 10 mil. It's gonna be 9 mil for you. It might work a little bit differently. You can go even with the last stick out, you can go 5-6 mil, depends what's what works for you the best. Amps 136, 136 amps for this root. Usually I go even with higher amps for this root, 140, 150, but 136, I think it's this is good. Even if you try with these amps, I think it should be good for you. Definitely, guys, practice. You always use amps, how much you can handle, how much you can follow. You know, you gotta adjust your speed. To your travel speed, how much you can feed in the same time and manipulate that puddle. The main thing is just to have control. As you can see here, even if you lose connection, if it disconnects, just aim that tungsten on the top or the bottom, or you can do like same time, you know, up and down until you reconnect again, and then just keep stretching that puddle. There's a couple different techniques you can use on a horizontal. This is the, I'll say, the easiest one. Just to keep it in the middle, keep it connected. You know, you want to have that nice liquid puddle. Don't rush too much forward. That's how you lose connection. As you can see here, a couple examples. You just melt that rod, and then you create that empty space, and then that's how it gets gap even more wider, open, grapes inside, you know. And this is the root from the outside, this is the root from the inside. This is good root, that's exactly what I was aiming for. As you can see, you don't see much stop starts because there's no any, and that's the goal with the horizontal, like with any root, even if it's vertical. You don't want to have too much stops. It's gonna be visible. Nothing's wrong if it's if you have too much stop starts, as long as the root is healthy, good and solid. Nothing wrong with that. But just a saying, you know, I like to have less stop, more consistent root will be. And this is another angle, another view from inside. This is gonna show it to tie in. As I showed before in my previous videos, couple examples on a tie-in, always pause a little bit before I connect. Usually dipping technique for tie-in, and pass over it and stop in the middle. And now I'm gonna show you example here. So once preheat, add wire, and then before that connection, before the tie-in, just to pause a little bit, dip, connect top and bottom, and just go over. And I usually stop on a half of the root, but in this case I just continue on, continue on. As you can see here, keep that rod in the puddle. It's in the middle, it's connected. Tungsten is always sharp. That's a really crucial thing, to have your tungsten sharp. And this is what actually manipulate that puddle, your tungsten, tip of your tungsten. It moves that puddle up and down. As you can see here, a couple examples, I lost connection and then just reconnect. No need to panic, no need to rush, just keep moving, side to side motion. Even if you lose reconnection, even if you lose connection, keep doing side to side. And once you connect again, just keep doing what you do. That's the best thing. As you can see here, another tie-in view. Now I dip a little bit tip of the tungsten, but it didn't contaminate that much. Well, it's a good habit. Even if you dip a little bit tip of your tungsten, you can use grinder and lightly just go over your root pass. Nothing gonna happen. You can use a buffing wheel, unless you really deep tungsten inside that you broke the tip of your tungsten. Then mark that spot and clean that out. Take a grinder and dig it out. And that's it for the root. This is how the root looks like on horizontal. There is a couple spots on a one tie-in. It's a little bit. It's a little bit different than the rest of the root, but that's good. That's a good root. This is what you want to have. This is what you want to aim for. As I said, guys, use amps that you can handle. You know, practice, go up and down 10 amps, 5 amps, you know, each time. And for the hot pass, run a buffing wheel. I switched to cup size 7 here, as 7 works good now for the hot pass. And just keep the rod in the middle and stretch that puddle up and down. As I said, there's a couple different technique on the root to feed that wire, to hold that wire. I hope I'm gonna show you if I got time to make another video with a different technique, how to hold on one side of the bevel and stretch that puddle. This is, as I said, this is the easiest one. Keep it in the middle and stretch that puddle. It's pretty much simple, guys. Once you dial in, it's not gonna be a big deal. All you have to do is dial in. That's it. You gotta burn to learn. There's no other way around, guys. And that's it pretty much for this video today. Hope you guys like it. Enjoy. Thank you for your support so far. I really appreciate it, guys. Appreciate all your comments, all your likes. All that positive good stuff keeps me moving forward. Thank you very much, and see you in the next one, guys. Take care. Play safe.